If Congress cannot come to an immediate agreement, the $600 unemployment checks that a lot of folks are getting ends in just a matter of days. Right now, Washington lawmakers disagree on what to do next. Today, Republicans announced their plan that would continue to offer payments to people who are laid off from their jobs. For those who do not have a job at all, they would see less money from the stimulus package than they currently receive. Time, of course, is running out. The current legislation that also blocks evictions and foreclosures also expires within a matter of days. Brad Trahan is an employment specialist with Express Personnel in Rochester. You represent between 400 and 600 people who are seeking jobs and help them find jobs. Brad, what is it that you're hearing from them? I know the concerns are plentiful. Normally, I should say, you represent 400 to 600 associates. What is that number now?
You know, right now it varies, Betsy, right now as far as where we're sitting at with our active associates. We're probably right in that 350 range. And the being is that obviously with the stimulus package running out, this 13-week stimulus package by the federal government of $600, it's created some unknowns. And this clearly is going to affect people on the sidelines who have been receiving this stimulus package. It was needed. But now what's going to happen is not only is that going to run out, not only does it affect our associates and people on the sidelines as far as their personal situation, but then the bigger draw is too is how does it affect our local economy as well.
And what is it that you're hearing on that end? Because before this pandemic, we had a worker shortage. We didn't have enough people to fill the multitude of jobs that we had.
You know, Betsy, it's when this happened in Rochester, we were at a 2.6 unemployment rate. And then all of a sudden in May, the last report, we were up to a 10.0 unemployment rate. We jumped 7.4% in a matter of 2 months. And so it was crazy. We were really looking for a lot of people. Interesting enough, though, through this series is that unemployment rate is a little misguided for the fact that while we did have some low, higher unemployment rates going on, we had a lot of these people seeking or retaining these stimulus packages, and they were making in many times more money than they would be had they been working. So, it still makes it tougher when you're out recruiting talent. We need to get people back to work, and what's that look like? Because, you know, we all have a purpose and we all feel better when we accomplish things. And that is essential in our day-to-day lives. So just as much as it's healthy to get kids back to school, it is also healthy to make sure that we get our workforce back to work.
Putting together another stimulus package, we don't know yet what it's going to look like and what the weekly unemployment benefit will look like. It could be a lot less under the GOP plan. They've been saying it most likely could be less than the $600 that people have been getting, and therefore that could incentivize people to really say, okay, I got to get back to work.
It is important. You're right. We do have to keep tabs on what's going on. And it's one of those things, Betsy, where growing up as a kid, my parents always say, don't spend what you don't have. So people that are on the sidelines kind of waiting back and seeing, doing the wait and see approach, that's not really a healthy approach because we just don't know what that's going to look like. There's, you know, things have to get worked out. I know they have dreams in Washington to try and get this passed here within the next couple of weeks, but we just don't know what that's going to look like. There's sometimes in life you just have to, it's better to be maybe working than not at all. I mean, it's really what it comes down to because it is again healthy for us. So we're encouraging candidates and our associates out there, you know, what does that return to the workforce look like for you? What are some of the obstacles that you feel? And we try and provide these resources. We have many opportunities for people are looking for work. You know, sometimes you maybe have to patch things together. It may be a job here and a job there, but if you have to make up that $600 a week and you'll be dependent upon that for childcare reasons, for grocery reasons, for utility bill reasons, whatever that may be, there's ways that we can mend it. And we all hope that this ends sooner than later, but it's going to be interesting to sit back and watch and see, but we do encourage people to engage, get back in that workforce, feel comfortable. And again, we're just really proud of what we've seen with our employers in southeastern Minnesota on the actions that they're taking to make it a safe workplace for their employees.
Jobs are available. What are you trying to fill right now on the local level that's out there for people to be applying for?
You know, that's a conversation, Betsy, we have with a lot of candidates many times. Many times we have opportunities of jobs that they didn't think they would foresee them in. For example, I helped a school teacher one time got out of that profession, and now they are in the manufacturing industry because that person had a good mechanical skill set and things like that. Our manufacturing is doing very well. We're seeing a lot of good things in industrial. If it's production, supervisors, mechanics, the trades, the trades are really booming right now as well. We get some office admin. There's a lot of variety.
When you say the trades, Brad, that is so broad. Break that down a little bit more. Get a little bit more specific, because as people are watching this and thinking, okay, I'm not going to do what I used to do because my employer dissolved and the job isn't even available anymore and I have to look for something else. Tell me what the trades means or what it looks like for someone.
Some of those trades are going to be your diesel mechanics. They're going to be your carpenters. They're going to be your electricals. They're going to be your plumbers. And what we're also seeing, Betsy, with a lot of employers nowadays is if they're getting these people, they're going to come up to show to work. They're not going to be doing these no-calls, no-shows. They have a willingness to learn. Many, many employers are going to take that time to teach, train, and educate that individual to learn this skill set. It's so important because, employers are they want the return on investment on these employees. They're going to put that time and effort in there. We see that a lot. I'm doing a couple logistics jobs right now, direct hire logistics supplies, and in the manufacturing industry. And the employer has told me, you get those people in there willing to learn, we'll teach them. That's going to be an $18 to $22 an hour job with full benefits. And that's what's important, too, is some of these benefits are going to be running out for employees. So we're getting these jobs with 401ks. We're getting medical benefits, things of that nature. So basically, what we ask and we challenge candidates that we work with is look in there. What are some of your hobbies? What are some of your interests? Are you willing to go outside of the box of what you've done in the past? And there's great opportunity for growth. Many employers that we work with have great opportunities for growth. There's always a starting line. You may not be getting that 3 or 4 weeks of vacation to start out like you were in your previous job, but if you go in there and do a knockout, bang out job, employers will recognize it and they're going to take care of you. They have retention bonuses. We have one employer that was so happy with the group that his people were doing in the shop. He gave me Friday, Monday off after holiday weekend, and they got a bonus on top of that.
Let me ask you this, though. A lot of folks over the age of 50 are thinking, I am too old to go into something new. I don't want to learn how to be an electrician or a carpenter. What kind of options do I have? And not only that, Brad, add this piece to it. There has to be some kind of counseling element to it, because there is a mental health issue with people who are over the age of 50 thinking, I don't want to make that big of a major life change, but I have to work.
It's very true. And one of the things that touches me and what we do is I'm in that category as well, Betsy. I'm 53 today, matter of fact, and we work with that all the time. And what we do is we coach our candidates and we bring out their strengths. Some of these candidates that we work with haven't had to interview in some time and they want to work, and we work with them. We learn about their strengths. We want to learn what they want to improve on, and we take the resources that we have learning from them, and then we go out to our clients and say, you know what, clients, these are the type of candidates that we have. This is all the experience they're going to bring into the table. It may not be, they may have had 15, 20 years in a previous job, so it may look a little bit differently. But what we're finding when we're working with our candidates, because when we work with our candidates, it's important because you hit the nail on the head. We just don't not coach them. We talk and we prep them for interviews. We tell them what to expect. We tell them to do research. And what we're finding is that gains confidence. When you work with them, when you guide them, when you teach them, it gives them self-confidence that when they're going to go in there and interview for that job, they're going to do just fine. So we actually walk them all the way through the path, and we walk our clients through the path. And when you bring everything together, then you have great long-term fits. And what I've also found is we've had situations where people have been in their position, it's been their only job, and all of a sudden there's been a reorganization, there's been a COVID layoff and whatnot. We work extremely hard to get those people back to work. And we're a tool, we're a resource, because when you do a search and when they're doing a search, it's a team effort. But you can just tell the relief when we're able to put these individuals back to work that they got income coming in, they got some benefits coming in, they're able to put food on the table, pay the bills. And I also say this, Betsy, we also have to have some fun in life, because with all the stresses going on, we got to make sure we take care of that.
It's a
step-by-step approach.
Let me tell you this. Saw something just this morning. This can be a blessing. It feels like maybe a very deep and dark valley for some people, but it really can be a blessing. Life changes can have a silver lining to them. And what I saw this morning was, whatever it is that you're going to do, don't treat it as work or a job. Find your purpose, make it a mission, and then you want to do it. So for all that you have said and what you do for other people, thank you. And happy birthday.